I am Santosh Gangadhar. Today I am teaching you the torsion. The subject name is mechanics of material. This is the fourth problem. I am solving it. A hollow circular shaft. It is a hollow circular shaft of external and internal diameter. The external and internal diameter. First they have given internal external diameter. That is D naught. 200 mm. It is a hollow part. Right here hollow. Hollow. Therefore, you have to consider R is equal to D naught by 2. 200 divided by 2 is nothing but 100 mm. And internal diameter DI, which is 150 mm, respectively, is transmitting power at 250 rpm. Small value, N value is given, 250 rpm. The angle of twist over a length is 2 meter. Length is given 2 meter. 2 into 1000. It will be 2000 mm. Was found to be 0.5 degree. Theta is given. 0.5 degree has to be converted in terms of radian. That is pi divided by 180. Pi divided by 180. You will get in terms of radian. Determine the maximum shear stress, that is you have to find out tau max or tau induced, and also find the power transmitted. Power transmitted, you have to find out the P value. The formula I have provided you. The modulus of rigidity, the 4 gigapascal, 84 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square. Use this formula, T divided by Jp is equal to tau divided by R, G theta divided by L. First, you have to find out the tau value. I will use the combination of these two. This is a hollow part. The hollow for polar moment of inertia will be pi divided by 32. DO raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4. This is the formula for polar moment of inertia. If it is a hollow section, I have to use these two combination in order to find out the torque. What is the T value? We don't know the T value. First, we have to find out the T value. Therefore, because this is also unknown, the tau also is unknown. But here theta is given. First, you have to find out the tau. Therefore, I will go for the combination of these two rather than combination of tau by T value. Rather than the combination of T and tau value. First, T divided by Jp is equal to G theta divided by L. T divided by pi divided by 32. DO 200, outer diameter is 200 raised to 4 minus 150 raised to 4 is equal to 84 into 10 raised to 3 into 0.5 into pi by 180 divided by length is 2000. Cross multiply, you will get 39.35 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. This is the torque obtained. After getting the torque, use the combination of torque and shear in order to find out the shear stress, or use the combination of shear stress and theta in order to get the shear stress. Either you can go for the combination of these two or these two in order to find out torque, shear stress. Now I am going for these two combination. I will write the formula directly here. Tau is equal to T divided by Jp into R. Substitute the value, 39.35 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi divided by 32, 200 raised to 4 minus 150 raised to 4 into 100. Into 100. The answer is 36.64 Newton per mm square, because it is a shear stress. Stress unit is Newton per mm square. Now we have to find out the power. This is the formula for power. P is equal to 2 pi nt divided by 60,000, has to be expressed in terms of kilowatt. Kilowatt. Power I have to express here. Power. Formula is P is equal to 2 pi nt divided by 60,000. 2 into pi, n value 250. N value is 250 into torque 39.35 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 60,000. Answer 824.14 into 10 raised to 3 watt. Further, it will be 824.14, this 3 will be, becomes kilowatt. In this way, you have to solve the problem. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.